Okay, so for stuffed zucchini, Italian stuffed zucchini, I have two zucchinis. I have one that I've already cut and prepared, and then I have one here. I'm going to show you how I did that. And then I have a half a pound of bacon that I've just cut into pieces. This is what came out of the first zucchini that I've cleaned, and it's just a coarse chop of the inside. This is maybe 2.5 cups of cut up bread. It's a soft bread, white bread. It's actually hot dog rolls. You know, it's summertime, so you may have an abundance of leftover hot dog or hamburger rolls, so I'm just using that. And roughly 2 cups of mozzarella that I've shredded myself. You can use the bags from the grocery store that are already shredded if you like. I've got about a teaspoon of Italian seasoning, about a tablespoon of minced garlic. You can use more or less according to taste, and salt and pepper to taste. I just have it kind of mixed together here. So first I'm going to show you how I do this. Just a second. Yeah, I'll use that. Okay. So you want to, first of all, you want to make sure that your zucchinis are clean, and I've washed mine. And you cut the ends off, the stem and the blossom end. Get rid of that. Okay. And then what I do is I want to see, you know, where the zucchini is going to lay, and it makes it easier to cut it straight. So then we're going to cut it lengthwise. And you need a big knife for this. It just seems to be easier. Okay. A big knife than with a smaller knife and trying to cut straight. Okay, so now you have your two halves, and then I use a spoon. This has zucchini on it already, and what I do is where the seeds are, and actually, okay, so this is a pretty big zucchini, but this isn't the giant zucchinis that you see. If they get too big, the seeds get tough, and we're gonna scrape that out, okay, because that's gonna be part of the meal. So you want good size zucchini, but you don't want the giant ones. Okay, whoops, oh my gosh, I almost lost that one. Something you can scrape it from end to end, or you can kind of scoop it. You just want to get that center seedy part out. Okay, so just scrape it out all the way down to the end. Kind of keep it round. And then see how that's uneven? What I do is I come back in and I just kind of scrape it with the spoon. You know, every zucchini is going to be different, so the measurements on this recipe aren't exact. And even with the zucchini, you know, sometimes the zucchinis aren't even within themselves. But we want to try to keep this pretty much even from side to side. So that's how it gets scooped out, kind of like a boat. So there's that one. I'm going to put that over on my tray here, and I'll show you that in a second. It's good to have a fairly stiff spoon. You know, this one's soup spoon or a tablespoon, and it's kind of firm, so I can dig into the meat. And when I scrape it, it's not going to bend or anything like that. So scrape it and get it clean and kind of uniform. I want it about a quarter of an inch thick, more or less. Because when this is cooked, you want this at least al dente, but pretty tender, you know, tender enough to eat. Okay, and that looks pretty nice. Right there, just a little more even. All right, and I'm gonna put this one on my cookie sheet. What I have here, I have a cookie sheet, and I just lined this with some parchment paper. Just to help with cleaning. It's probably still going to leak around the edges, but it just won't be so sticky. So that's over here waiting. And I'm just going to give this kind of a coarse chop because we're going to cook it down. So and it's a quick wash. Now, I got a nonstick pan. I'm setting the heat at medium high, and I'm gonna go ahead and put the bacon in there. So the bacon's already cut up. You can see it into small pieces, and we just want to brown that pretty good. We're gonna get it pretty brown, so we're gonna let the pan heat up, and we'll brown that. Okay, so it's starting to sizzle. You can hear it. See the bacon grease is coming out. Just want to stir it around. It's going to break up into little pieces now. Oh my gosh, I love the smell of bacon. You could do this in strips and break it up if you like. To me, it just is easier to cut it and have it all kind of uniform. They will shrink down. Not completely, of course. And we're not gonna, it's gonna be pretty crispy. I'll show you. Some of these things you kind of have to do by feel. So, just stirring it around. And you do know, depending on how much bacon grease comes out of this, this looks like it's pretty fatty bacon here, actually. I like the size of that one. Don't do what I'm doing, unless you have tough fingers. Anyway, we want it to cook down. Oh, I know what I was going to say. Yeah, depending on how much grease we get out of here, bacon grease, I might take some out. We'll have to see. But we always save bacon grease. You never throw bacon grease away. Okay, so let's just give it another stir. You see it's starting to brown up a little bit. Bacon always spatters for some reason. It just always does. But yeah, it's getting there, but we need to cook it a little bit longer. And you know, the thing about when you cut it up like this, it doesn't matter if it curls or not, because it's just little pieces, you know, that you have, you know, it's all going to be broken up, separated. You got to keep an eye on bacon, because bacon gets to a point, like, where it's not quite done and then all of a sudden it's burnt. So you really gotta watch it. I don't like burnt bacon. Okay, it's real close now. And you can see there's a lot of bacon grease has come out. I don't cook these completely crispy for this. You can if that's the way you like it, but I just don't do it for this recipe. If I was eating it for breakfast, yeah, I'd want it crispy like that. So, okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take it out now if it's about the way I like it. So I'm going to scoop this out. Y'all probably think I have asbestos fingers now, but I really don't. But I don't want it to cook anymore just yet. And I'm going to be adding it back into the pan in just a minute. Now that's a little bit too much bacon grease there. So I'm going to get something I'm going to pull right out of that. I'm going to take about half of this. I don't trust that bowl. Hold on a minute. I'm going to use this because I think that other one might melt. So, like I said, by about half. Okay. And we're going to save this for something else. Now I'm going to take the cut up squash. I'm going to go ahead and put that in there and start cooking that down. And what will happen here is any little bit of bacon that's stuck to the bottom, it doesn't look like much, but if there is, it's going to bring it up. And we're going to cook this down so it's almost mush. There's some here, so it'll lift that up. You see that? That's just flavor there. Okay. So we're just going to let this cook. And we're not worried about these chunks because they're going to cook down to almost nothing anyway. Alright, so let's let that cook. Okay, so you can see this is starting to get juicy and it's picking up some of the brown off of the bottom. I am going to break it up just a little bit. I want it, this has to be cooked well done. You want this completely soft. So it's got a ways to go. We don't want it all dense. We want it soft. Like the inside of the squash, if you're frying squash. It's almost there. Look at that color. Doesn't it look good? And it smells good. And all we really have right now is the smell from the bacon, but it already is starting to take a wonderful smell. I don't really want any resistance. When I squish on it, I don't want any resistance. I want it to be squishy. Look at the color. Oh my goodness. See, it's got all that browning from the bacon off of the bottom of the pan. Okay, I think we're there. Yeah, that's pretty soft. Okay. I'm gonna put the bacon back in. Just it'll cook a little bit more, and it will render a little bit more grease. Not much though. But I'm gonna take whatever's in this little bowl here. Anyway, put that mixed together. I'm gonna turn the heat down a little bit because I don't want that moisture to cook off. And I think I'm gonna put the seasoning in first. Italian seasoning, the garlic. And a little bit of salt and pepper. That's to taste. We're gonna mix it around. Oh my gosh. Just give it a chance to heat up those herbs and the garlic. I have the temperature set like on medium. Now it was on medium high when I was doing the browning. Everything to blend together. And right now it looks kind of gooey and icky maybe to some. It's the marrying of these flavors though is what's going to give the finished product all the flavor. And it won't look like that when it's done baking. Alright, so we got some juice. The garlic smell coming up and the herbs. Not the cheese. We're going to feel our way with the bread, so we're going to add a little bit. Because remember I said, you know, not all zucchini's the same. They're all different. They're all different sizes, and they all have different, moisture content. So this is something you're going to have to kind of feel your way through. But you want the soft bread. You don't want hard bread because you want it to soak up the juice and be fluffy enough to be a binder, but not so fluffy that, or not so dry that it's crunchy. Add a little bit more. I don't know if we're going to use all of this or not. We'll have to see. And what we're doing right now is we're just seeing how much of the bread is soaking up whatever bacon grease is there and the juice from the zucchini. See, it's starting to look better now. It doesn't look like goo anymore. Not a bad goo anyway. It started to look like something it's supposed to be. Now, I'm going to tell you guys a little secret, okay? I don't like onions. Sorry. So, some of my recipes, a lot of my recipes, you're not going to see me put onion in, but you could put onion in this recipe. You want to cook it till it's translucent, okay? But I don't like it, so I don't put it in here. Not in this recipe. There are some things that I use it in, but very little. I'm going to add just a little bit more bread. I don't think we're going to use it all. Okay, I'm going to set that to the side. So I'm just going to work this last little bit of bread in. In this recipe, I like that you can see the difference between the bread, the bacon. You can still see, because of the seeds, you can still see parts of the zucchini. This one had really tiny, or these two had really tiny seeds, so they're in there, but there's a piece of zucchini there. It is in there. Okay. Just tuck it in. All right. So I'm going to turn this off, and I'm just going to move this over a little bit because we're going to start adding cheese. And I'm going to add it in a little bit. And this is real mozzarella. You can use provolone if that's what you have. I like mozzarella. It gets stringy and gooey. And you'll see as it melts in. I'm going to try to mix it all together. Look, it's already starting to string. Just keep mixing. I'm not going to use all of this in the stuffing either because we want a little bit to go on top of the zucchini. So, it's cheesy, all right. And we want this nonstick pan because the cheese is going to make a mess. As you can see, it sticks to the bottom. So we want something that's going to clean nicely. See how it all looks. Mozzarella is so creamy. You know, when it melts, it's really creamy. Leave like maybe 3/4 of a cup. We don't need a lot to top it because there's so much in it. And actually, depending on your preference, you could just mix it all in. Like if you had a larger zucchini and you needed it and mixed into it. These are smaller, so I'm not going to do it. And look, just mix it in. Sticking to my spoon. That's pretty good there. See how gooey it is? But it's a good gooey. Okay. I'm going to move this out of my way. I'm going to put it over there. Now it's time to stuff. So, this is pretty easy. Just take it and you put it in your boats. You want it to mound up a little bit. Sorry about that clanking. I watched some videos and there's noises that are all natural part of making the process of whatever it is that you're doing. But it irritates me. Like I watch Dr. Sandra Lee, the pimple popper, and I love her. I know this may be something we shouldn't be talking about right now, but I don't like the sound of her gloves. I hear her gloves and it drives me nuts. So I'm sorry about the clanking on the spoon. And more on this one. I'm using my fingers, you see that? My hands are clean, I swear they are. My hands should always be clean. I don't know if I mentioned it or not in the beginning, but you want to make sure you wash your zucchini too. You know, just you want to keep everything clean. You don't know who's been doing what before you bought something, so always make sure you wash your vegetables. And I'm just making sure that everything's in there, that there's no air pockets. Or a little bit, as little as possible. Some are a little fuller than others. That one's got a little. Every last bit. Okay. And then we're going to take this last little bit of cheese and carefully. These are kind of big pieces. And this is one of the reasons why I put that parchment there. Baked cheese is a mess to clean up if it gets on your pan. You don't want to waste it either. Although I love it when it gets that brown burnt. taste, to me it tastes good. More up here. You don't need to sprinkle it on real heavy because there's so much in the stuffing. And like I was saying earlier, if you have a big one and you need to mix it all in, it's okay because this will still brown. A little extra on this one here because it has less stuffing. Cheese. Love cheese. Okay. So we got the stuffing on. We're going to put it in the oven for 30 minutes. It's a 400 degree oven. So, I'm sorry I can't show you my oven, but it's right here in the usual place. So put that in there. There we go. And I'll show you the finished product in about a half an hour.
Hey, what's up?
Okay, so. The zucchini's done. You can see how nicely brown it is. It looks so good. It's very hot right now. So I'm going to give it a minute to cool down and then we're going to do a little taste test. Okay, so here's the finished product. And I'm going to do a taste test. I can't eat this whole thing, but I'm just going to cut a little bit off of here. It's very hot. Can you see the steam? And the zucchini, the shell part of it, is a little al dente. Cut a little bit more. Okay, here we go. Let's see if I can do this without burning myself. Oh my gosh. There are three things you cannot go wrong with, okay? Cheese, bacon, and summer squash. This is delicious. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you thought this was a good video. And don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Bye.